had a dream about you last night.
As long as it's a good dream, that's all that matters. So how you been?
God has given me strength, placed me in my right mind, and I was able to wake up and see another beautiful sunrise. So I am blessed. I would ask what you've been up to, but this says everything. Seems like you and that old man can never make peace.
Can you blame me though?
The bickering within a family at times can seem never ending, but the one between you and your father is epic.
Oh, Mom.
Out of all the blatant and untrue allegations coming from Oakwood Times, they have never stated our ill intentions behind home care. Yes, we support a low-income program that helps the residents of Bullock Park move into Hazelbrook, but what's so sinister about that?
Home care is backed by Fillmore, the same mortgage corporation that was under controversy for its unethical accounting practices and loan rates that caused millions of homes, not only in Oakwood, but nationwide, to go into foreclosure.
Everything you just stated are allegations and are still pending. So as far as I'm concerned, I will not comment nor acknowledge that statement. What I will acknowledge and confirm is that home care is backed by a few members who at one point in time were employed by Fillmore, but they are not involved in the allegations you're speaking of.
Pamela Alvarez of Oakwood Times is stating that the intentions are to move the people out of Bullock Park just to renovate the area and move in the rich and upper class.
Sounds ridiculous, doesn't it?
You tell me, Councilman Bailey. Hypothetically speaking, if all the residents of Bullock Park were to move, what would the council plan to do with that area?
I can't answer that. All I can say is that our intentions are true and honest.
Why can't you answer that, Councilman?
Because that question is irrelevant to our main objective.
Which is?
What's best for the people of Bullock Park. This isn't about permanent relocation. It's about an alternative, and a safe one at that. There is a major crime wave happening in Bullock Park. The council is trying to do our part in helping those citizens who want to leave the area but can't afford to. I'm watching the news this morning, and I see a story about a young girl who was killed in her sleep by a stray bullet.
Yes, Keisha Lewis.
It breaks my heart to hear about that poor little girl. It's getting so chaotic in Bullock Park that sleeping in your own bed has a fatal risk factor.
Now, if her family had moved to Hazelbrook, she would have been alive today. The crime rate is bad in Bullock Park. And let's face it, the Oakwood PD is not as efficient as they should be in that area.
I don't care what Police Chief Crooks is saying about lowering the crime rate, because as far as the people in Bullock Park is concerned, they can't see it.
What a great father-in-law you have.
Yeah, I'm the luckiest fucker in the world.
Fucking cocksucker. So where to?
Sugar Lips? I got a tip this morning saying that the altercation that took place at the liquor store started at Sugar Lips.
Interesting. Let me see if I got some ones.
So what does all this mean? Because I'm not hip to none of this.
All this means is that I would be the new owner of Michelle and Laurent's house. So I'm their new landlord. The only difference is that you don't have to pay rent.
Why not?
Well, to simply put it, your nephew is my son's client. So anybody who does business with my son, their family is in good hands with me. So this will finalize everything.
Oh, thank you so much, Cheryl. You don't know how much this means to me.
Oh, trust me, I do. Come here, sweetie. Give me a hug.
Thank you. Thank you so very much.
Congratulations. You two are on your way into being what you never would have been in Bullock Park. Home owners. This house is yours, free and clear.
Beautiful flowers for a beautiful lady on a beautiful day. Smile, Stefan.
And to top it off, she forgot her anniversary.
Oh dear.
It's more like we're roommates or strangers sharing space.
Well, how's the intimacy?
Far and few, and when we do, there's no passion, no excitement. I mean, we haven't had sex in over 4 months.
Have you at least expressed these concerns to Laci?
I used to, but I got sick and tired of the same outcome. I tell her how I feel, she'll promise she'll do better, she'll act right for about a week or so, and then go straight back to the way things were. I want to call it quits, but at the same time, I don't.
When I was married to your father, the last few years was very rough, as you and your brother witnessed. He neglected me in many ways, and the way you sound right now is the way I felt at that time. I was unhappy, but I couldn't leave because, to be honest, I was afraid of what was out there. All I knew was your father. When we graduated from college, we were young, passionate revolutionists.
Dad, a revolutionist? That Uncle Tom bastard was a revolutionist?
Believe it or not, Ciara, he was. I don't know how he turned into the person that he is now, but then he was so passionate about our people and his community. He wanted to make a change, but unfortunately, he ended up being the one that changed. Anyway, when we moved into our first apartment, we had to pay $50 a week for rent.
$50? That's it? That's $200 a month.
At that time, Ciara, that was considered pricey, and we struggled every week to scrimmage that up. But we did it. And the love we had was so validated and strong. I would think back to those days and try to recreate that magic with your father. But by that time, it was too late. We were two different people. Once I accepted that reality, it was then that I was able to let go. And for the first time in my life, a strong peace came over me. I felt free. So what you need to do, Ciara, is to ask yourself, is this marriage worth saving? How does this marriage feel to you at this point?
It feels like a roller coaster. You know, when it's good, I know there's no other place I'd rather be, but when it's bad, I don't want to be there at all. She's not treating me like I'm a priority. You know, I'm not first. For Laci, it's her parents, her job, her DVR, and then me.
In your heart, do you still love her?
Yeah, I do love her. But as far as me still being in love with her? Honestly, Mom, I don't know.
The Oakwood PD is not as efficient
as they first, the mayor cuts funds from our department, and now this.
All of the slander that Eddie Bailey is doing is just downright despicable.
Oh, he's lying to the people, giving them false information. He even had the nerve to insinuate that I'm fudging my numbers. Fucking unbelievable.
I guess since you won't roll over and play fetch like Walker did is why he's being so malicious against you.
Yeah, that and other things.
What does the mayor have to say about all this?
Nothing, as usual. Playing it safe, acting like the peacekeeper and all of this.
He's just doing what he has to do to stay in good favor with the council.
But I'll tell you this, John. I'm getting to the end of my rope. I've called Eddie several times trying to squash this whole thing, but he's either not in the office or he's in a meeting. I'm starting to think that he's avoiding me. Hey, I'm trying my best to stay diplomatic and professional, but there's only so much that I can take.
Hey, Polecat, I thought about what you said, and you were right about everything. But you have to believe me when I say that I have changed, baby. I'm clean, and that's a big deal for me. You have no idea how easy drugs get snuck up in here. I'm back to reading my Bible and praying more. When I get out, I will do right by you and Lisa. I miss you, girls. I wish the two of you would come visit me. I got something to tell the two of you. And I want to tell you in person. P.S. I like the care package you sent me last month. Mama.
Mike Wilmer.
Bands make her dance. 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 Bands make her dance.
Bands make her dance. Bands make her dance. All these cheeks poppin' pussy, I'm just poppin' bang. Bands will make her dance. Bands will make her dance. These cheeks clappin' and they ain't using hands.
Me and another girl was dancing for these guys. They kinda like our regulars or whatever, cause they come here like all the time.
Do you know their names?
Trouble and Kane. I remember one of them saying that they were from Shago or somewhere like out Midwest or whatever. Anyway. We dancing for them or whatever. And then some Southside Grim guys walk over to them. And one of them says something like, y'all some bold ass niggas for showing your face around here. We know you the ones that clap Diego. And then Trouble got up and got in that guy's face and basically challenged the dude like, all y'all slobs getting mopped up. And then fists started to fly. Drinks was being thrown. And me and the other dancers ran for cover, but security broke it up, though.
Tell me something. What kind of gangs frequent here?
Mostly Southside Grim. Bounty hoods will come in here sometimes, but it's very rare. Lately, some new fools been coming. I heard there was some out-of-towners.
From where?
Shago. The girls love them because they ain't stingy with their money. One night, they was up in here, them Shago fools, and they spent damn near a half a meal. This is the parking lot view. As you can see, I'm escorting the fools to their car. They were the ones that started the fight that night.
Emilio, didn't you tell me that the car that witness at the liquor store described was an old model red car?
Yeah, these two guys fit the description. See the green jacket?
Can you zoom in on that license plate?
I can try.
Perfect. So, all of this is connected to that home invasion on Dobson.
I was thinking the same thing, right when that dancer mentioned Diego.
Drugs, money, and murder.
Isn't that what it's always about? Cars registered to a Dorothy Miller. She resides in the Carter Projects. Is that car in your possession?
No, my eldest drives that car.
And what's his name?
Earl Miller.
Does he live with you?
He don't live here anymore. I kicked him out for hiding some drugs in my house. This is a Christian house and I don't play that.
Do you know where he lives?
I don't know. I know I have my ups and downs with my son, but blood is blood and I don't know what your intentions with my boy is.
Ma'am, Your son is a suspect in two murders, one of them being Keisha Lewis.
Please don't tell me he has something to do with that little girl getting killed.
I can't say much about the case, ma'am, but it's looking very likely that he might be.
We need to find him. Do you have any idea where he could be?
You have nothing to feel bad about. You did the right thing.
I know. I'm not tripping. Especially off of him. I just want to know if you're okay.
For the longest time, I haven't had a good night's sleep. Always going to bed with a busy mind. It's hard getting any rest. Between the house going into foreclosure, and packing, and looking for a new place, and dealing with Sean and the new baby and whatnot. This will be the first night in a long time that I will be able to close my eyes and relax. And I have you to thank for it. You get home safe, okay?
For sure.
I love you, Ricky.
Love you too, Mimi.
What do you think you're doing?
I was just leaving some memos for Mrs. Thomas that she was inquiring about.
So why were you on her computer?
I was just sending an email that I forgot to send earlier today. And I turned off my computer already, so I didn't feel like going back to my desk. Since I was dropping off these memos and Mrs. Thomas leaves her computer on, I figured I could send the email here and drop off the memos.
As of today, you are restricted from entering any council member's office in their absence. Do I make myself clear?
Okay, yes, sir.
So yeah, I saw him and I stepped right to him and said, I want it. Give it to me now, you know, so shit. He gave it to me. Bitch, you know how I do. I get mine, you hear me?
Oh, snap, this is my jam right here.
Wondering where you belong. Let me help you find yourself. Cause you don't need nobody help.
Yeah, shit, that's my song right there.
The bar, they so light-skinned. Shit. Hi, I like me light-skinned, nigga. I ain't mad at you. Hi.
I can't help but think about my Teddy listening to this.
Y'all still haven't patched things up?
Sadly, no, girl. He's all paranoid thinking that his wife is gonna find out about us.
Well, Twan, he does have a lot to lose. You can't blame him.
I know, girl. I knew what I was getting myself into messing with a man like him, but I still miss him, though. Anyway, what is up with you and that fine brother from Fillmore Realty?
This man is amazing. He sends me flowers. He is so damn down to earth. And he makes me smile all the time.
So what's his profile?
He's 36, a Libra, which is perfect. Cause we are compatible. He's divorced. But he got no kids. Yay! He has a college degree. He drives a nice ass car. And he lives in Crown Heights.
Ooh! Oh, he gots to have money for sure to be living in that area.
So y'all done the nasty yet?
You fucking tramp. I don't want him to think bad of me. Shut up. He seems like a real cool guy. And he's cool peoples. And his intentions seem to be good. So I'm going for it, girl.
The triple homicide case and that home invasion about a month ago in Ocean Crest is linked to the murders on Hudson Street and Gage.
The triple homicide case and that home invasion about a month ago in Ocean Crest is linked to the murders on Hudson Street and Gage.
The altercation started at a strip club, where the deceased victim, Kane Malloy, and his friend Trouble were confronted by men who accused them of killing Diego Jacobs, the top drug supplier from Southside Grimm. An argument and fight ensued. Security broke it up. Both groups had to leave the club.
We've obtained footage from a security camera in the parking lot that shows two of the suspects leaving in a 1970s red Ford Mustang, the same car that a witness at the liquor store described.
Evidently, the suspects followed the victims to the liquor store, opened fire, and shots were fired back. Kane was shot and killed at the scene. The other potential victim, whom we only know as Trouble, fled on foot. The gunmen chased after him, but lost him.
So, any word from this Trouble?
Well, it appears that he doesn't want to be found. A lot of people in East Limit and Westside Bullock Park aren't talking. We assume that Trouble is in hiding. The red Mustang car. Any leads on that?
Yes. The video footage from the parking lot was good enough for us to read the license plate. Emilio ran it through the database, which led us to one of the suspect's mother, Dorothy Miller, who was at first unwilling to say much about her son, but when we laid down the facts to her, she changed her disposition.
We got a name, Earl Miller, but he goes by the name Dillinger in the streets. He's 20 years old and a member of Southside Grimm. His mother gave us some numbers and addresses of where she thinks he might be.
But most of them turned up cold.
We put out an APB on any cars on the road that fit the description of the red Mustang in question.
What about the other suspect?
We have no information on the other suspect. We believe that once we can find Miller, that we'll be able to find the other suspect.
We already briefed the gang task unit. You calling it a day?
Yeah, I need to lay it down. I'm exhausted. Been working on this case for 20 hours straight. I need to refresh myself.
Get some rest. I'll call you if anything arises.
Where are you going all dressed up?
To an art venue.
What, Eddie's?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me? We could have went together.
I thought you had other important things to do. I know that Scrubs is having a marathon tonight, so I don't want you to miss that.
What's with the attitude?
Laci, do you remember what the 9th was? Wow, you are fucking amazing. Our wedding anniversary, Momo. You forgot our anniversary, but you remembered a television show? How do you think that's supposed to make me feel?
Well, why didn't you say anything?
Because it's not my job to. You're supposed to care enough to remember things like that.
That is so childish. You're pining all over this house instead of being a woman and confronting the situation.
You have the nerve to talk about maturity? At least I have my priorities in order, unlike you, a 34-year-old woman that's still running behind mommy and daddy.
Now that's uncalled for.
I am sick and tired of feeling like a second-class citizen in this marriage. You put your parents, your job, even your friends before me, and I'm sick of it.
Ciara, I hear your frustration. I'm sorry.
Ah, save it. Save it, shovel it, and can it, because I don't want to hear it. The word sorry coming from you is as pointless as a broken pencil. You know what? This shit is for the birds. I'm out.
Thank you.
The inspiration of these pieces comes from a variety of places, from my past experiences, my travels, dreams, and visions I've had. However, the root of all my inspiration comes from my mother. She's a leader, a free spirit, a survivor. I am the manifestation of her. I love you, Mom.
Oh my goodness! Come here, girl!
Hey, Mama Z. You looking stunning as usual.
Why, thank you, Ginny. You're still the beautiful lady that my son should have married years ago. It is so good to see you.
It's nice seeing you too. I missed you so much. You know what I miss? I'm in desperate need of some of that cha-cha tea.
Well, you know where you can find me. My cafe is still up and running. Oh my God! Is that Michelle Obama? You two gotta excuse me. I gotta go.
Why would you betray me like that?
Because you're a non-motherfucking equivalent to the equation, bitch.
Did this bitch just call me a non-factor?
The real homewreckers of Prescott Park will return after the...
I am proud of the work and the notoriety that has come his way. He possesses the true raw essence. He could live anywhere and chose to live in Bullock Park. The heart and essence of where real art is captivated. I'm proud of you, son, which furthermore proves that us as city council is for the people of Bullock Park. Don't believe the hype. Get the hell out of here.
I need a drink.
Ain't they serving champagne in there?
I need a real drink. I'm talking about some Jack with his buddy Daniels. You hear what I'm saying? For real, I need something for real.
Yeah, I got the remedy. But you can't leave your party.
Well, yes I can. The party's ending in a half an hour anyway. I won't be missed.
All right then. Hey, let's roll then. Let's do the damn thing.
We're all set and ready to go. I knew you were going to Oakwood for spring break, but I'm happy that you decided to go with me. I didn't want to go back home and spend it alone.
I'm glad you offered. I would have had nothing much to do.
Let's bust this joint.
This world's so crazy, I'm gone. In the zone, I'm just writing my song. Pray to God,
here
holding on to my rights are wrong. And no blunts, that's a right, we can light the bomb. I get higher than style C, N-O-2. I'm number one when I walk in, you N-O-2. Abbreviated, yeah, you came up short. Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant in this game, nigga, this my sport. In the ring with the shit, beam with the gift. By the boom, by the bing, I'm the king of the pin, mobster. I should come equipped with a suit and a roster. Whole team eating duck and soup with the lobster. Baby girl fresh, Jimmy Choo's in the closet. Next to the guest, thank you for the profit. I just wanna get a million souls. Without the devil still in my soul. I'm just chillin' like a villain with the cold. Tryna get a million, we gon' get it when we blow. First we gotta flip it, then we cook it when it grow. Chillin' by the kitchen, they ain't kickin' in the door. I'm just kickin' in the floor like I'm stuffin' on the ground. If you didn't know me then, I'ma let you know me now. Got a problem with the kid, get up to get down. 9 times out of 10, you don't wanna go around with him. Thinking it's a joke and get riddle. Come through like Trey Vaughn with a hoodie and some Skittles. And beat on a nigga like a fucking instrumental. Knock the teeth out a nigga, make him need a Western Dental, huh? Yeah, I know they fit. I know they fit them like a pit bull on the track when they say sick. I'm a colossal, muy macho, call me big. Opposite B, I'm the feces, I'm the shit. Say that money like Lil Dick. She asked for my money, I said, bitch, please. I grew up both Snoop and Corrupt. If we don't save them now, we don't give it up. Where's my cup? Put it in my left hand, the right is my blunt. And I'm so high, I'm lying right by the sun. The knees up hot too, this track might burn. I'm cooling like the AC in the fan. Cash on delivery, cold as a clam. We going down in history like the white man with a high level conscience. We did the right plan. Black fists up while I'm doing sit ups. Gotta stay in shape in case the world trying to get us. In case we got a brain for us, run. Cause they're shooting them guns. Yeah, the battle's been on, but the war just begun. Now we on it all day. Remember, you used to shoot craps in the bathroom. Had the tricks in the left hand. Used to work niggas by the hallways. That was a throwback Thursday. My nigga got shermed out. Used to be the hardest nigga.